Julia Scotti, a very funny comedian who is also transgender. How you doing?
I'm groovy. How you doing?
You're always funny, lady. What do you think? Is this a breakthrough?
I'm a go-to trans person, huh?
Huh? You're my go. Yeah, you are my go-to trans person. When I get in trouble, this is where I come.
Well, you're not in trouble yet.
Yeah, right. Give me time. All right, so what is it? Is this a breakthrough here, or is this a goof or a tribute to the Kardashians, or what do you think?
Well, personally, I read this story, and you know, I think it's wonderful. It looks like the school is supporting her. Looks like the kids are supporting her, and good for her. You know, survive and thrive. That's what it's all about. I'm for it, you know, but then again, I'm prejudiced.
Right. No, I don't think.
I don't understand why it's a big deal in the first place. She identifies as a girl.
Right.
Treat her like a girl. You know, if the captain of the football team became homecoming queen, then I would say you had a story.
Okay, but what if? I mean, do you have to have the operation in order to be truly transgender, or is this just a guy imitating a girl?
Well, neither. To be transgender does not, the surgery is really the icing on the cake. If some people choose to do that, many people choose not to do it.
Right.
If she identifies as female, then respect her for that. That's all I'm saying. If the rest of the student body wants to, treat her as female, that's wonderful. If they don't, they should mind their own business.
Right. So is this a breakthrough? Do you see it as a breakthrough, like for other schools?
Well, she's not the first one that this has happened to. It's happened, you know, around the country, but there are so many. It's every victory counts. This whole thing is about little victories. You know, there's never going to be one gigantic victory. Each time we break down a barrier, it makes life a little easier for the next kid to come along, or the next adult to come along, or the next comedian to come along.
Well, you were lucky. You had your humor. You had your humor to get you through it, and get you to the point that you are now. But it wasn't easy. How hard is it for someone, you know, a senior in high school to come out and deal with it?
Well, it's hard to be a senior in high school under the best of circumstances. And again, it has to do with how her peers treat her. If it sounds like they're doing a great job with respecting people for who they are.
Right,
and if she and her parents, obviously her mom is behind this, and supportive of her. She seems like a happy kid. God bless is all I can say. You know, I think it's a wonderful thing. I think it reflects more on the kids in the school that they're able to rise to the occasion and maybe teach some adults a lesson about tolerance. You know.
Yeah, and that's the perfect example, because it was the school, you know, there was accusations that they stuffed the ballot box, but they deny it. And you could hear that it wasn't true by the ovation that she got when she was elected.
I didn't see the video, but I did read the story. And if she got an ovation like that, that's wonderful. I'm a former teacher.
Mm-hmm.
So I know what that, you know, that environment can be like. And I know that it could have very easily wound up being, like the movie Carrie, where they kind of, set her up. Doesn't sound like that here. It sounds like these are good kids who really support their classmates. And, especially in this day and age with all the violence in schools, wow, you know, it's a great example of kids getting along and doing the right thing. And that's not to say she should have been forced to win. No, if she ran against other people, and they elected her anyway, then she won. That's the story. She won fair and square. Great.
That's Julia Scotti, very funny comedian, transgender. And she's been on here in New Jersey 101.5. We've had her on for an hour telling her story. And this is, you would say, in New Jersey, a breakthrough. And anytime you come on, it's a breakthrough. And I want to thank you for coming on.
I break through the walls. Can I give a plug?
One plug. I got to hit the news. Go ahead.
All right. I'll be at PJ Wellens tomorrow night in Cherry Hill. It's an LGBT P-flag. Fundraiser. So if you're around, come on down and say hi.
You got it, kiddo. We'll talk later. Thanks for calling New Jersey 101.